退。
谁打死的老
退，
没有死的话，白墙里的水开了山，还有谁把爱的人带回去？为何说我太也飞了？为了谁？
Hello.
Hello, this is Kellen.
Hi, kid. How are you?
I'm fine. How are you?
Good.
I decided that I wanted to, read your book, My Life in Baseball, and I really enjoyed it. I decided to do an interview, and I really wanted to talk to you, so...Now's the time.
All right.
When your skills developed, did you ever think that you would make it to the big leagues as a professional baseball player?
No, I never thought of that. As a youngster, I would listen. Probably 12 years old, I started having a great interest in the Cubs. I lived in Springfield, Illinois, and people either rooted for the Cubs or the Cardinals. We thought they were bigger than life.There wasn't television, it was all radio, and I didn't imagine myself ever being in that level. I would just play for the day and let it go at that and try to win that game and then wake up the next day and look for something else.
Can you retell the story about your workouts with the Phillies?
In those days, you weren't drafted. You were asked to work out with different clubs and you could sign with whoever you wanted. And I made arrangements to come up from Springfield to work out with the Phillies when they were in Chicago. And I worked out for 3 days. And that's when the Cy Perkins, my coach, after the first day, I heard him say, don't let that kid get out of here. So I knew somebody was impressed. And I worked out and they offered me $10,000. And the next day they offered me $15,000. The next day $25,000. Yeah, that was an awful lot of money in those days. I had always promised my mother I'd build her a home, and when I got to 25, I said to the Phillies representative, would that build a home? And he said, yeah, that'd build a nice home. So I said, well, that's enough.
After you signed with the Phillies, you had another steak dinner. How did that come about?
We took a train ride from Chicago down to Springfield, Illinois, and so my father could sign my contract with the Phillies. And on that train ride, the scout had asked me if we were going to eat dinner, and I had a nice steak, and he said, did I like it? And I said, yeah, it was great. And he said, would you like another one? And I said, yeah. Well, it turns out later he told me that he was only kidding, but I accepted him, and I had another steak.
Reading in your book that you met the great Babe Ruth at least once. Can you recall that meeting with the Babe?
Well, I was warming up in spring training my first year in Clearwater, Florida, where the Phillies trained. And as I was warming up, I looked up and the Babe Ruth was walking by with one of the sports writers, a man named Sam Bumgardner, who used to write for the Philadelphia Inquirer. And I thought it would be awful nice to get a baseball sign for my mother.And I did. I walked over. I took a ball out of the bag, a brand new ball, and walked over. And I asked Stan Bumgarner if he could loan me his pen. And then I asked Babe if he would sign. And he said, yeah, kid, I'll sign. And he could hardly speak. He had throat cancer. He died that August from throat cancer. But he was the most congenial. And he signed the ball. And they tell me now some people will pay $10,000 for the ball, but I still have it. It's something that I one of my prized possessions as far as sports memorabilia goes, of course.
Let me root for the home team. If they don't win, it's a shame. Cause it's one, two, three strikes, you're out at the old ball.